technology classes. In this video we are going to learn about how to import data from Excel file to MS Access database. We have steps for this. We will see the steps first, how to import. Here you can see we are going to have these four steps. The first step is that first you have to create Excel file with some data. And the second step is that we have to create a database in MS Access. And then after we have to create the fields per table. Finally, we have to import data from Excel to table in the MS Access database. So first we go for the first step, that is creating Excel file. So here you can see I already created some data in the Excel file that is related to student. So here you can see the data. This data contains five fields like roll number, name of the student, brand, email, mobile number. And before going to import this data, you have to ensure that all the entries in the Excel, means each and every cell contains some data. Okay, so that data entries should be in the text format. Text, you have to make it as the format of the cell in the format of data in the cell should be a text. So here you can see, I'm going to select all the data and just right click, and you can select format cell. There you have to keep it text and click on OK. So now every cell contains the data as text. So like that you have to create the data in the MS Excel. Here we created 9 rows. Now this is the data we are going to import to the table in the MS Excel. So now we go for MS Access. So click on start button, start button, and here you can see Access 2016. Just click on that. Suppose I want to create a blank database. So here you can see the button for to create a blank database. Click on that. And it will be asking for the name of the database file. And I am giving the database name as student. And then click on create. So now a student database is created. And by default, one table is created in this database. So now we have to create the fields for the table. So that is the third step that we have in the slide. That is, we have the second step is that we are going to create a database in the MS Access. And the third step is that we have to define the fields for the table. Now we will define the fields for the table. So while defining the fields for the table, we have to be cautious that the table field name should match with the column headings that we defined in the Excel table. So now to define the fields for the table, just right click on table and click on design view. And it will be asking for table name. I am giving the table name like xData. And click on OK. So here you can define the fields for the table, that is xData. By default you will get one field, that is ID. So I don't want that field, just I'm going to remove that field. I'm going to define my own fields. So we have to define the fields according to the column headings that we defined in the Excel file. According to the Excel file, the first field is that roll number. So that we have, we declare data type as short text. And the name of the student, that is S name. Again, that should be defined as text. And branch. Short text, email. So while defining the fields, you have to be careful. The field name should match with the column heading we have in the Excel file. And we have one more field, that is mobile number. That is also we define like short text. So like that, we have to define the fields for the table. Then we have to go for the fourth step, that is now we can go for importing data to the table that we have in the Excel file. So just save, and now you can right click on the table and you will get an option called import. And from that import menu, you have to select Excel. So we are going to import, we are going to get the data from Excel file that we are going to keep in the table. So select Excel. So you will get a wizard. So there you have to select you have to give different inputs while passing through the wizard. The first you have to select the file name, that is the Excel file, so that contains the data that you want to import into the database. So click on browse, and I save the data in the desktop, that is S data. Select the file and click on open. Next, below that we have three radio buttons. The first radio button for if you want to import what are the data you are going to import from Excel file, that if you want to insert into the new table, you have to select the first radio button. Already here we created a table, in that we want to insert data from Excel file. So the better option is selecting appending. We are going to append the data from Excel file here. And third field is for if you want to get the data from some other external source, you have to select the third radio button. So here we are selecting the second radio button. Why? Because we have already table is created here, and we are going to append the data from Excel to the table. And click on OK. And you can see all the rows are imported, and you can also observe that the first row that we defined in the Excel sheet, that is treated as column headings. Okay, the column headings that we have in the Excel sheet are converted to field names, match with the field names in the table. And click on next. And already it is, we are going to import data to the existing table, that is S data. And click on finish. And click on close. And if you open S data, there you can see the data that we defined in the Excel sheet. Okay. So this data you can able to modify, and you can able to use for doing further processing. Thank you.
Now, please subscribe for more updates of this channel.